Let's say we have a particle p right here, and at some time t, it is a distance x away from our origin. This line right here is our origin. Now we wait some amount of time, so at time t plus delta t, this particle has moved, it's moved over here, and we'll call it q. So in a time delta t, it has moved from point P to where it is currently at point Q, and it has moved a distance of delta x. So this means that point Q right here is a distance of x plus delta x away from the origin. And this change in distance over this time interval, delta t, is called our average velocity. Average velocity is delta x over delta t. Now, if we had continued and we wanted to take smaller and smaller delta t's, so instead of from here all the way to here, we took our delta t, our time interval, to be from here to here, or even smaller, from here to say here. As we approach zero, so as we approach an infinitely small delta t, we're going to get an infinitely small delta x. And this is called our instantaneous velocity. So our instantaneous velocity. And it's defined as the limit as delta t approaches zero, so it never becomes zero, it just approaches zero, of delta x over delta t. So the limit as delta t approaches zero of the change of distance over the change of time. And this can also be written as the derivative of x with respect to t. And we'll use this shortly. But these two different types of velocity is best illustrated with an example. And in this example, let's say we have a guy who is running from point A to point C. At point A, he's running at 8 meters a second. At point B, he is running at 6 meters per second. He's getting tired. And point C, he's run for a while. He's really tired. He's only running at 1 meter per second. Didn't really train for this race. So we also know that point A is when we start, and it's our zero. And point C is where we end, and it's 100 meters away. So this distance is 100 meters. The other piece of information we have is he was able to run 100 meters in 20 seconds. So this entire time took 20 seconds. From this information, we're able to calculate his average velocity. So his average velocity is equal to the change in distance over the change in time, which is 100 meters, over 20 seconds, or 5 meters per second. However, at different points in the race, or when he's running, at point A, his instantaneous velocity is 8 meters per second. At point B, it's 6, and at point C, it's 1 meter per second. So this demonstrates something that's pretty important. The instantaneous velocity does not need to equal the average velocity. They can be different values. But his average velocity is over the entire distance, while the instantaneous velocity is at a specific point. if we go back to particles, and we have some particle P at a time t that has some type of velocity, so a velocity v, we wait, and at a time t plus delta t, this is p, so now let's call this one q again. It has a velocity v, and it has a bigger velocity, which is a delta v. So it's a v plus delta v. What does this mean? This means that this particle now is moving faster than it was before. So this is the acceleration of the particle. The average acceleration is equal to the delta v, change in velocity, over the change in time. And again, like velocity, we can have an instantaneous velocity, an instantaneous acceleration. And this is equal to the limit as delta t gets smaller and smaller and approaches zero of delta v over delta t. So the limit as the delta t approaches zero of the change in velocity over the change in time, and this can also be written as dv over dt. There's a couple of other forms we can write the acceleration as. If we go back to what we figured out the instantaneous velocity was, we have v is equal to dx over dt. If we use this expression and we substitute it into what we know for a, so a is equal to dv over dt. If we plug this v right here into this v right here, we can say the acceleration is equal to d dt times dx dt, or d squared x over dt squared. So this right here is also a perfectly valid expression for acceleration, as well as this right here. Now, if we can obtain one more expression, if we solve this equation right here for dt, so dt is equal to dx over v, and we plug dt into this expression for acceleration, we get acceleration is equal to dv over dx over v. And if we simplify this, we get the acceleration is equal to v dv dx.